big VT-120 triax, undoing the rat's nest. Put a zip tie here, the brown and black wires. There's another one here on the red and green. So let's unweave the weave. Alright, this red one here. These two, and it's the second one in. Blue. We'll come back to these. So here. Black wire. Is the middle on this? This is the ground switch. These two brown wires are on the standby switch. From the switch. In order to remove the circuit board. Green wire and the braid with these two red ones. These two red ones are in this position right next to the hole. Black one here. This is the lower wire on the power switch. Allegedly, circuit board is not fastened outside of this line. So this is flexible. Lower black wire on the main switch. Upper black wire on the main switch goes into the second row. Last knot. Last knot. Easier to get to after removing this big black one right here. This one goes to the auxiliary output jack. Then there's this black wire here, is on the mains cable. So where does this go? this is the top wire on the ground jack. And then this. This is the top wire on the power switch. Have you ever seen such a mess? Okay, now back over here, this white wire is the transformer, main transformer, that guy. This white wire is the, let's back this up, second position here, goes to the auxiliary outlet. This white wire is on the mains cable. And if I pull that ground, get that out of the way, these two wires here on the ground, there's the main ground, one goes to the board over here. No, wait, wrong. One goes to the power cable, and one goes to the auxiliary outlet. Phillips screwdriver. Got some goop on. Five sixteenths. Something on it. Aha. Lock washer on both sides. So, where are we? Okay. Black wire right here. This one is the bottom of the ground switch. Black wire here is the black wire on the transformer. Now what's left? Yellow wire, purple wire, yellow Yellow's here by himself. Purple's over here, kind of also by himself. And then these two green and whites, just here by themselves, right next to the one of the fuses. Okay, that is everything at this end. Look ourselves up a little bit. Now we have the rest of the board. These are reverbs. Let's get rid of this. Let's get rid of this. Okay. This is the conductor from here down over next to the power switches. That'll have to wait until we make some room. Okay. This one here. Wire has no marks. This one's black. This one's the clear. The other reverb wire, it has a black mark on it. Black wire here, clear wire there. Black wire, there's an S. I'm going to say that's the send. These two right here is an R. R is over here, S is over here. Okay, now we have fun. Just go down the line. First we have an orange wire. Then we have a brown wire. And we have a green wire. Ow. And we have a bit of an injury. Black wire, black, black, yellow. That's all of that. And we're bleeding. Okay. Tubes. Tubes have to come out. Tube layout chart is on the back of the board. Three in the front row closest to the power transformer is the AU7. Two in the middle, these are the small tubes. Four big tubes in the back. Excuse the elbow. Testing using these button-based Sovtex. Bias them hot. At least that's the trick I've heard. There's my elbow. Check it out. Now we want to Okay, don't know where I shut off. Anyways, let's try to pull the bottom out of this. Pull the circuit board out. I don't know if this is going to work without pulling this front board out. This runs along right here. And then this is the main board. It has all the knobs, and then there's even another one below that. So, that doesn't work. And these are held on with spacers from below. Just to make it even more fun. There's a screw on the top, these little guys. There's another one on the bottom, and there's a spacer in the middle, like Chinese finger cuffs. So this will be most exciting. Depends on which side of the thing actually decides to turn. I guess you can say it's a solid mechanical design. Maybe. Whether or not the board's flaky and all that other fun stuff. Lots of talk about junky circuit boards and junky soldering, and I'm not seeing a lot of soldering issues. I'll retouch everything here just because it's good practice. And it looks like this thing has some repairs on the soldering at some point. There are a few joints that look cleaner than others. I'll be sure when I put this together to Loctite the standoffs to the other side. Over here, all of these along the circuit board, these are the power tube sockets, all four of these. And so the power tubes are very well supported through the board, which is generally a bad way to go, but they did a very good implementation of a very cool concept. Same screws. Alright. I think I can actually get this. Hey, easy. Okay, that looks like all the screws and all the fasteners and all the electrical stuff, and I'll just bump the camera all unprofessional-like, because, hey, I'm not a professional. And, oh, right, okay. We are held in by all these jacks here on the back row, and probably this, and these, and everything else, which means that the board has to come out nose first, which means that our second circuit board needs to come out before the main board can come out. Those are 11:32. Are not 7/16. What do you want about the 12? All works. Can actually see what I'm doing. How about that? Into this video. See if it cuts out in 10 minutes, like YouTube style. Something goofy or something. Okay. Front circuit board comes up. But it's connected to the main board. So now we move back here. To the trusty crescent hammer. More plastic bits, another knob for the presence control. And I think we need to look down. Pull these two. Stick them in the bin. And then one last potentiometer. Maybe, just maybe, let's hang this up. Be careful if you go sticking your fingers in under the circuit board on one of these, because got a lot of transistors hanging off the bottom side of the board, and if you're not careful where you grab it, you might just snap something off that you wish you hadn't. Screws coming through. We have four adhesives on this. I think we have some. Unless I just need a hammer on the power tube sockets. Oh, you know what? But that is it. I'm willing to bet power tube sockets. Screwed to the chassis, and then I can see underneath we've got long legs going from the chassis to the board. So just to make things even more interesting, well, that's annoying. Yeah, this seems to flex up to where the power tubes are located, and then it doesn't flex anymore. Okay, tube sockets are fixed in place with these screws. Thing falling down. It's going to be all kinds of fun to put back together. I think the standoffs will be mounted to the circuit board from the backside. Mount those to the circuit board from the backside, and then we'll be able to put the screws in from outside the chassis and lock down the tube sockets. Back. Got a little stand over here. Alright, now this is here. Yeah. That's there. Thing whereby we somehow wiggle and remove 10 pounds of shit from a 5-pound bag. Okay. Standby switch is giving me a little bit of an issue. These might be given some issue too. These are the reverb lines. Yeah, cool. All the power tubes are up and out of the way. Get the nose up. Oh, this is going to be fun. Look at all the parts that need to be put in place before you can put other parts in place. Look at all those things. Well, the good news is everything fell off, kind of. Oh, we got carnage. Oh, I love seeing carnage. Yes. We have carnage. All right. What are we looking at? Well, the first thing is, I don't know what those are yet, but they are blown the hell up. Seem to be okay. 350 volt, 220 microfarad. Those are definitely be hard to find these days. These, I think, are 350 at 100, 450 at 47, 450 at 47, and then 16 volt 1000 back here. 270 ohm, 5%. Okay, this exploded. This is what took down the power supply. Right there. And that exploded. And that took those down, whatever these are. Yes, these exploded. Tube socket looks pretty solid yet. Here's the bottom of a vacuum tube, just trapped. Side of there, I'll get that out later. 470, 470, these look like screen resistors. Okay, over here on this side, this is all your solid state controls and tone shaping and garbage. Oh, alright. Reverb transformer. Classic. All the damage is on the high volt side of the circuit. And that's something I can deal with. I'm going to have to look up parts layout and figure out what all this stuff is. You can, that looks really shiny. That blew up really hard right there. So not cool. Okay, this is all around the bias circuit. Which, the strange thing is, when I tested it, guess we're not going to refocus. When I tested it, the bias circuit worked. And then this guy here is good. We'll have to probably change these out. 63 volt, 47 microfarad. All right, this is all bias controls. And we'll change out these three big sandbox resistors and the power amp. I don't think I'm going to be able to get these, which makes me a bit sad, but I was actually getting power through the power tubes. If you put it on triode mode, which connect the screen grids straight to the output of the tubes. Got a nice blue glow that way. But if you ran it in pentode mode, which takes screen grid voltage from the other end of this resistor, so it's apparently not getting there. Get no blue glow, got no current on the bias probe. So, now all three fuses are good. None of the fuses blew up, and this is the kind of damage we got. No fuses exploded. That says something about trusting fuses. Definitely don't put bigger fuses in there. I don't think anybody changed fuses on this because you see how easy they are to get to. So yeah, we'll find values on all these guys. That looks like a 470 showing up under all that crud. This looks like toast. And swap out parts. These are your main filter caps. Probably won't be able to swap those out. That makes me a bit sad because these are old enough now that it would be a good idea to change them. But what's the point if you can't get replacements? Or you can't make them fit. These are Marcon capacitors. Camera isn't going to focus that close. I guess it's a little farsighted. 350 volt, 220 microfarad, 470 volt, 47 microfarad. Don't have any idea what the quality is on those. I've never heard of them before. BC test by Keith A. 07A by Sarge. And we have a number here, 07-226-01, second row. 0390-035-059. Okay, it's an Ampeg VT120 Triax. A little bit dirty over here. This was in the back corner under the vent. That's not terribly surprising. So we'll get this one rebuilt and turn it around. Cabinet's in really nice shape. This is a working amplifier, so it's not perfect, but it's in real great shape. Little stain on the grill cloth. I'll be going out with Eminence Texas Heat Patriot, because that's what I have that can handle 120 watt tube amp. And I changed out the speaker mounts for T-nuts. I'll trim those down a little bit and paint them a flat black so they don't show up through the grill cloth. And we'll get this guy flipped out. Later.